हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू साइफिलिक एकेडमी। आवर चैप्टर ऑफ डिस्कशन इज एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर। लेक्चर नंबर 3 इज गोइंग ऑन। इन दिस सेशन फ्रेंड्स, वी विल सी सर जॉन डाल्टन्स एटॉमिक थ्योरी। बिफोर बिगिनिंग विथ हिज पोस्टुलेट्स एंड एटॉमिक थ्योरी, वी विल जस्ट हैव अ ग्लिम्सी ऑफ हिज बायोग्राफी, बिकॉज ही वॉज वेरी ग्रेट एंड इंटरेस्टिंग साइंटिस्ट। ही वॉज बॉर्न इन ए पुअर Weaver's family in 1766 in England. Mind it well, friends, this British scientist was born in a very, very poor family, even though he achieved this much great knowledge and he proposed several great theories who were the building blocks or the foundations for next research. And he began his career as a teacher at the age of 12. Just imagine, friends, when he was just 12 years old, he became a teacher, and he spent his most of his life in teaching and researching. The great British scientist, friends, one more interesting thing about him, the great British scientist John Dalton was bachelor throughout his life, and Sir John Dalton has proposed his atomic theory in 1808. Friends, as we learn and as our observation says, all the historical theories proposed on what has been learned from the prior theories or prior postulates. And even Dalton was not the exception for this. His atomic theory basically depends on the laws of chemical combination. The two laws of chemical combinations are law of conservation of mass and law of constant proportions. All you guys have learned this in 9th standard, but I'll just brief you what is law of conservation of mass and law of constant proportion. Friends, law of conservation of mass is nothing but if you take any chemical reaction, the mass of reactants and mass of products, total mass of reactants and total mass of products will be same. That is, mass of reactants will be equal to mass of products. For instance, we will consider a reaction. A and B are two reactants, are giving C and D two products. Let's assume they are KLmn grams each. So after the completion of reaction, mass of these reactants will be K plus L gram, will always be equal to mass of products. Total mass of products will be M plus N. If we consider a chemical reaction of hydrogen and oxygen, it gives H2O. It is not balanced reaction, half molecule of oxygen. One more interesting thing, friends, in Dalton's theory, molecule word was not there. He used the term compound for diatomic substances. If we consider this reaction, if 1 gram of hydrogen reacted with 8 grams of oxygen, then we will get 9 grams of water. You will not get 10 gram or 7 gram of water. Exactly, you must get and you will get 9 grams of water. So friends, that's what exactly is the definition of or the concept of law of conservation of mass. That is, mass can neither be created nor be destroyed during a chemical reaction. And what is law of constant proportions? Just now we have seen the example of water molecule. Friends, what exactly you observe in water molecule? Two hydrogen atoms are combined with one oxygen atom. mass of oxygen is 16, mass of hydrogen is 1. So total mass of hydrogen in one molecule of H2O will be 2 grams of hydrogen will combine with 16 gram of oxygen. That is, ratio of hydrogen to oxygen will be 1:8. Now if you take any water sample from Himalaya to tap water, the ratio of hydrogen to oxygen will always be 1:8. This was the concept behind law of constant proportions, that proportions of individual atoms will remain same. So in bookish definition, we can put these two laws in this way. Law of conservation of mass is, mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. And law of constant proportions is, in a chemical reaction, the elements are always present in definite proportions by mass, as we have seen in the example of H2O. So Dalton used these two concepts to propose his atomic theory. So let's begin with his postulates. The first and very most important postulate he proposed is, all kinds of matter are made up of small and tiny particles called atoms. Friends, the word atom is derived from Greek word atomio. Atomio means indivisible. He considered atom as indivisible, and some Greek scientists and Indian philosophers in the 500 BC considered atom or Parmanu as indivisible part of matter. The first and most important postulate was all kinds of matter. Friends, what does it mean, all kinds of matter? If matter is there, that can be a pure substance or mixture. If it is pure substance, that can be element or compound. Element like chlorine gas, oxygen gas, these are elemental forms. And if you take hydrochloric acid, HCl, this is compound form. Hydrogen is attached to chlorine, NaCl, all these are compound forms. And if it is mixture, that can be homogeneous or heterogeneous. Homogeneous mixture means what? Solution of salt in water. And what is heterogeneous mixture? Salt plus, you can consider salt plus sugar as the example of heterogeneous mixture. So friends, you take any kind of matter, whether it is element like chlorine, oxygen, like, or compound like HCl, NaCl, or homogeneous mixture like salt in water, or heterogeneous mixture like salt in sugar, all matter is made up of tiny, small, indivisible particles called atoms. So this was his first postulate. What next he proposed? Friends, if you consider atoms of one kind of matter, like this tire, If you consider atoms of this tire, all the atoms will be same in size, shape, structure, mass, and their chemical properties. If you consider this gold bar, all the atoms of this gold bar will be same in chemical properties, their mass, shapes, and etc. And if you consider this compound NaCl, even in this case, all the atoms will be same. But if you compare the atoms of this rubber tube with gold bar, these two atoms will be different. That is, atoms of same compound, atoms of same compound will be same, and atoms of different compound will be different. Atoms of same substance will be same, and atoms of different substances will be different in their size, shape, and most important, their chemical properties. One more interesting thing, friends. When a chemical reaction takes place, what part of matter takes part in a chemical reaction? For example, if you react, what is this? This is photo of salt. Salt is nothing but Na plus Cl gives NaCl. So this reaction takes place at atomic level. Means atoms take part in a chemical reaction to give a compound of fixed mass ratio. If we generalize it, atoms combine to give a compound of fixed mass ratio. As we have seen in law of conservation of mass and law of constant proportions, their mass will be in fixed proportion. And in addition to that, friends, these atoms combine in the ratio of whole numbers. For example, two hydrogen atoms are combining with one oxygen atom. So what is their atomic ratio? That is 2:1. And if you take any sample from Himalaya to tap water, the proportions will remain same, whether it is mass proportion or their atomic proportion. That will not be different in any kind of water, or let's say you take sample of that matter from any source, like you take rain water, tap water, or sea water. The proportion of hydrogen and oxygen will remain same. So friends, these were the important postulates of Dalton's theory. We will just summarize what all postulates we have seen as far as Dalton's theory is concerned. All matter is made up of very tiny particles called atoms. Atoms take part in a chemical reaction. That is, reaction takes place at atomic level. Atoms of given element are identical in size, mass, and chemical properties. Atoms of different elements have different masses and different chemical properties. Atoms are indivisible particles which can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. I would like to add few points over here, friends. If you take any chemical reaction, in that reaction, atoms only rearrange among themselves. Atoms won't change. For example, if you consider formation of chlorine gas from chlorine atoms or sodium chloride from sodium and chloride atoms. these two chlorine atoms just combine to form Cl2, or Na just gets combined with half chlorine to form NaCl. Here atom of Na or atom of chlorine will not change. Atoms won't alter. They just rearrange among themselves to form compounds. So atoms are indivisible particles which can neither be created nor be destroyed. In a chemical reaction, they just rearrange among themselves. That was the sixth point. Atoms rearrange during chemical reaction. Atoms combine in the ratio of small whole numbers to form compounds. We have seen H2O, example of H2O, they combine in 1:2 ratio, one atom of oxygen and two atoms of hydrogen. The relative number and kinds of atoms are constant in a given compound. For instance, if you take water, the relative number of atoms, you take any sample size, relative number will be two hydrogen atoms will combine always with one oxygen atom only. If you take salt molecule, salt compound, one sodium atom and one chlorine atom will combine to form a NaCl compound. That is, relative number will always remain same. You will not find any sample with three hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. The proportion, relative number will always remain same throughout that matter. Okay friends, these were the Sir Dalton's atomic theory's postulates. But in upcoming research, and the research done by next scientists have proved, atom is not the indivisible part of matter. Atom has some subatomic particles. We will learn in due course that is, atom is made up of protons, neutrons and electrons. So friends, this is all about Sir Dalton's atomic theory. Thank you friends. If you have not subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe and share with your friends about this channel. Thank you friends.